It is season 11, people, and season 11 rhymes with heaven. And we're starting off this season with a bang! Yeah, buddy! We are so excited and so grateful for you guys for supporting the show from day one. I'm your host, Miao, yo, Piao, yo, Chomi, yo, Bra. And today we're paying a visit to Untimitive Dance Company. They've been doing an amazing things, people, and they are preparing to represent South Africa in Croatia. Dance now, people. I hope you guys are ready to have an amazing day with us.
Like toffee, sip like coffee, wake up, change your mind and drop me. Love to hate me, crazy, shady, spit me on like hot wasabi. Lick me up, I'm sweet and salty, mix it up and down my body. Love to hate me, praise me, shame me, either way you talk about me. I love the way you talk about me. Look at how far I got me. The shit the papers write about me. I folded up like origami. Like she ain't wearing no clothes. What you going so low? I bet they're gonna break up. But what the hell do you know?
Ooh, baby, you.
It's you.
I can feel you hating on me. Ooh, baby, you.
Yeah, you.
I'm glad to be your inspiration. Ooh, baby, who's.
Guess who?
The topic of your conversation. I am.
All the ugly things you say. Come and say them to my face. Stick like toffee, sip like coffee, wake up, change your mind and drop me. Love to hate me, crazy, shady, spit me all like hot wasabi.
Lick me up, I'm sweet and salty, mix it up and down my body. Love to hate me, praise me, shame me, either way you talk about me. Uh-oh,
watching me, uh-oh. I ain't watching you. Face. Stick like toffee, sip like coffee, wake up, change your mind and drop me. Love to hate me, crazy, shady, spit me all like hot wasabi.
Lick me up, I'm sweet and salty, mix it up and down my body. Love to hate me, praise me, shame me, either way you talk about me. Sip like coffee, wake up, change your mind and drop me. Love to hate me, crazy, shady, spit me out like hot wasabi. Lick me up, I'm sweet and salty, mix it up and down my body. Love to hate me, praise me, shame me, either way you talk about me.
Toffee, coffee, hate me, shady, hot wasabi. Stick like toffee, sip like coffee, wake up, change your mind and drop me. Love to hate me, crazy, shady, spit me on like hot wasabi. Stick like toffee, sip like coffee, wake up, change your mind and drop me. Love to hate me, crazy, shady, spit me on like hot wasabi. Stick like toffee, sip like coffee, wake up, change your mind and drop me. Love to hate me, crazy, shady, spit me on like hot wasabi.
Towards the end of 2016 is when we transitioned into a company.
So the big break that I think happened in 2016 when we had a viral video come out cross platform, YouTube, Facebook, all of that.
It's not only the long hours of training but us being a family. And we have certain things that we do always before we go onto stage,
sure.
Like praying, like
There's like a quote that says, dance to express and not to impress.
It's a walk with Mel, people. We are so excited. The Untimitive Dance Company, they're in the building, you best believe. That's how we do it out here. I'm very excited to be here. And I mean, you guys started way back. A lot of people don't know the story, but how did it begin? How did Untimitive Dance Company begin and how did it evolve into a company?
Okay, so we started as Untimitive in 2012. I used to have a team called Primitive and a team called Untamed as far back as 2009. And then in 2012, we merged the two names and the two groups together and it became Untimitive. We didn't want to have like a regular name like Shadow Dance Company or whatever. We wanted to have something that is like unique.
I know.
So yeah, that's how it started 2012, and we were just a competitive team. That's like all we did. And then in 2016, like towards the end of 2016 is when we transitioned into a company. We started taking on corporate and commercial work.
Wow.
And we...
That's when
we transitioned into a company and we started actually working and like and earning money and actually being professional dancers in a dance
amazing.
Company. Yeah.
So cool. It's a journey, no? Diverse throwback. And then I wanna ask some of you guys, how did you guys start dancing? Just a bit of an introduction. Matthew, we're gonna start with you.
I actually started dancing was in 2013.
And remember I taught you. Wasn't I one of your mentors?
You're hectic.
joking.
I started in 2013. I slept over at my friend's house and he had dancing. And then I just came with, and then I sat, it was in the studio actually, with Jose. And he was like, why don't you join? And then that was my first dance class. And then that's how I started.
Wow, and you're still going? Look at Zoe. And your side, Devon.
Hi. No, joking. I actually started dancing. It was a school project on like in primary school. Like the teacher was like, you need to come up with the dance and stuff. And that's how I grew passion for it. Like made crews and dances. But I actually battled the genre in school, so. That's how it all started for me.
Hey, so, from the battle life to the crew life. So hello, Manscap. And then, I mean, a lot of people see the results. Like, even you see you guys in sessions, it's like, yo, you're so clean, you're so on point, you know? And I'm going to go over to my British accent. And I want to know how, I mean, people see the results, but how, what is it? What is a day like with Untimitive Dance Company?
Well, for me, it's actually really stressful.
Really? Oh, come on, no offense, guys, but you're a lot. They're like a lot to deal with.
But I love them. But, like, usually when we have rehearsals, it's minimal 6 hours a day.
Wow, wow.
And especially when we get like really, really close to competitions, then lucky day.
Thank you. Isley or was it Ashley?
No, I just had to do that because, you know, they teach me how to speak like palette.
So you didn't know?
No, I
didn't. Oh my gosh.
Just for like dramatic effect, you know.
And to fit in.
Yeah, because I can't say in like my accent, like Dan Rick Dedeng.
No.
But like what was like, it's stressful, but as like a family, being so close as we are, like we build one another up. Because I remember this one time we had an overnight rehearsal, and I completely lost my balls. I was screaming, I had a panic attack, and they were all just really there for me. And like I wouldn't be able to do that if this wasn't a family.
That is so beautiful. I love the lisp. You've got the British lisp, hey? I see. I hear that. I gaan nou oorgaan in Afrikaans. Kyk hierdie ene ding is die Zontas. Zontas wat jy op my. When was a big break for you guys?
So the big break that I think happened in 2016 when we had a viral video come out cross-platform, YouTube, Facebook, all of that.
Sure.
And that just brought a lot of attention to us, even though before the like Untimitive was releasing videos and doing comms, like doing the grind or whatever, that was the moment that people were like, whoa, who are these people? Do you know what I mean? And then also another moment I think that really put us on the map is when we won Music Video of the Year, Osama.
It's the album. Hello.
So yeah, that's when it all, you know, kicked up and started up for all of us.
We kick it up. It's an Untimitive Dance Company in the building, people. We're taking a quick break. Don't go anywhere. Yeah, buddy. And we are back, people. It's a walk with me. I like a walk with Untimitive Dance Company because I'm enjoying this interview and enjoying the journey. And I know a few, but I'm even learning more. So we spoke about the Me Too video earlier, and that is when things just changed up in this life of Untimitive Dance Company. Why do you think, Mandy, why do you think things change, or what made that video different? Because you guys have been making videos. What made that video different specifically, and why do you think it went viral?
So when we, when Rudy posted the video, there was a hashtag said Megan Trainor Dance Essay. Mm-hmm. And we asked everybody to use the hashtag when they shared it. Mm-hmm. And it went crazy when everybody shared it. They actually asked other people as well to use the hashtag. And I think the hashtag
kind of made people
help.
Wow, that is amazing. That is dope, my bro. Rare of our levels. Yannicka, lachal klaar. Yannicka, say go for ons vandag. Like, why do you think you guys are consistent? Because whatever competitions you guys enter, you either win, which happens most of the time, or you place top three. Like, how do you guys stay so consistent?
I would say it's because of all the long hours of training. Mm. And I must say, basically, I've been with Rudy for 9 years, going for 10 years. So I must say it's been a minute. Yeah. So I must say that it's not only the long hours of training, but us being a family. And we have certain things that we do always before we go onto stage.
Sure.
Like praying, we have this one thing called One Touch, where I want to touch everybody and
is
everything.
It?
Yes,
you,
yes, because
that's
I touch, that's my thing, okay, fine, but I'll touch you guys, I love you guys. And then also, we don't let anybody get us down.
Yay!
That's the thing.
Because it's a tough industry to be in. It's easy to be
true.
Like, yay, what kind, you know,
mm-hmm.
But
exactly
I love it. I would need to my sister, I would buy narrow road, loving it, and I'm even taking inspiration from that, because it get stuff for you guys, but it's cool that you guys have each other. Then Rudy,
come on, say
for me. I mean, I know that you do more than just choreograph when it comes to videos.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us more about that, because it's costumes. You need to direct. You need to. It's a lot of things.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about
mm-hmm.
that.
I basically direct the videos mm-hmm. too. I create all the shots and how I want it structured, mm-hmm. and
sure.
I do the camera movement, or like I explain to the videographer at least how I want the camera movement done.
Mm-hmm.
And so I basically construct the whole video and how I want it to look and feel and all of that. And then sometimes as of recently, I've started styling some of the videos as well, because I really like doing that. It's quite fun. So that's also fun. I really love fashion and I'm very into clothing, so that's a very fun aspect. And then once it's all put together, then it goes off to my very good friend Willem, who edits.
Shout out to Willem.
He edits, color grades, finishes
wow.
it, makes it look professional and great, and he puts in hours and hours and hours to make sure it works out. So there's a very it's a very big process.
That's beautiful. Hopefully you direct a new movie soon.
I hope so.
I want to play in it, thanks. Okay, so then I mean, vision board wise, have you ever envisioned something and then it happened?
Yes, most people that are sitting here have been in my house,
sure.
So they know that I've
I'm glad to hear that.
Actually, I think almost everybody. So I have a whiteboard in my apartment, and I write everything down on there that I would like to do individually,
sure.
as a company. I write down video projects that
mm-hmm.
we need to do,
mm-hmm.
which sometimes takes a while to so I believe in putting what you want to do out there in some kind of physical way, so that you can be reminded of it on a daily basis. And I've written down things that have literally materialized in front of my eyes. So I just really believe in that process and having a vision board, because I think it brings structure for you to be able to commit to achieving what you want to achieve.
Well said. Hashtag vision means what lekker is. So but the break, just stay there, okay? Taking a break, being back after this, talking about Croatia and dance star. Yeah, buddy.
Thing I see over there.
wanna be me too. I'd wanna be me too. I'd wanna be me too. I walk in like a timepiece. I go straight to VIP. I never pay for my drinks. My entourage behind me. My life's a movie, Tom Cruise. So bless me, baby, yeah. And even if they try to, they can't do it like I do.
Yes, people, at this Bayleke event, Untimitive Dance Company. I'm having a ball with you guys and finding out about what's happening next. I know we're going to talk about Dance Day as well later, but I want to know, what inspires your movement?
For the most part, there's like a quote that says, dance to express and not to impress.
Sure.
And I feel that's like such a big thing in our community that you sort of, as much as you may learn and take from other people, it's very important that you sort of stay true to what you believe in your body and in your dance style. And I think the biggest thing in this crew that inspires me is, like, I'm not scared to explore the masculine and the feminine. It's like, we don't have these particular gender roles.
Hey!
Like, we don't have these sort of gender roles. You can sort of do what you want to do. If you want to crotch grab, if you want a hair flick, you can do it no matter who you are.
It's about art.
Yeah,
and bro, I thank you. Yeah, bro, I love that. And then, I mean, this is a very, very important question for me. Have you gone through a painful moment and it actually ended up being enlightening?
Okay, cool. Well, for me, actually, it's going to get really personal. In last year, 2018, one of my new friends at varsity committed suicide. And it really affected me because she was a new friend and like we were on the student body together. And like I came to one rehearsal and I told Rudy and I literally burst into tears. But at that exact same time, we were busy gearing up for Cape Town's Most Wanted, 2018. And I just found it to be such a God moment that we were doing an emotional piece that was dealing with bullying, cyberbullying, and almost hinting at suicide also.
Sure.
And I think as a family together and doing that routine, it really helped me see the light in the situation.
Sure.
So, yeah.
Yay! Thank you. There's a show from Alice, no? As emotions as Alice. Thank you so much for sharing that. Because not a lot of people are comfortable with sharing that. And it's so cool because dance gives us hope. You know, it gives us hope to keep on going. And I mean, you guys have done amazing competitions. You've, like we said earlier, been consistent and everything. But I mean, dance stars happen. Ooh. And that's why we're actually here. We're actually here to appeal to people just to get on board and just support these people. Kiki, yo, naam gaan ook groei. Dus Andre, Nike, Adidas, jylle allemaal wat kyk, ja. If you get involved, your name will get, I mean, you know what I'm saying. So I'm going to speak to you. You're going to tell us about the competition, Dance Star. You guys are prepping to go to Croatia. But tell us about the competition, what it was like for you guys.
If I'm, yeah, speaking from experience.
Yeah.
Don't so.
In Afrikaans or Kosaans?
Nee, so right.
It's alright.
Dance has been the best competition I've ever done.
Wow.
Most fun, most cultural.
Sure.
you literally, like, you'd walk into the lobby of the hotel and you have, like, Spanish people,
sure.
Mexicans, Czech Republic, and they're all, like, everyone's speaking a different language, but everyone loves dance. Yeah. So, same passion, different languages, and it was just, yeah, that's just really awesome. And this is my first time doing it with Untimitive.
Yeah!
You know, you can't say, you can't look into the future, but either way, I know that you guys are going to do well, you know. We believe in you guys, and we want everyone who's watching, say if your neighbor, if your oma, your sister, your auntie, for amo, if you guys need to get on board and just support our own people. Because if one of us wins, like we all say, we all win, that's how we do it. If there's people watching, email address, how can they get on board?
So we have our email address, untimitivedance@gmail.com. We are on Instagram as Untimitive Dance. We have a Facebook page, Untimitive Dance Company. Those are all the social media platforms you can find us on.
Awesome stuff. Any last words? Anyone want to say anything? Ashila, fine.
Go watch Wasabi.
Yes, Wasabi. Yes, people, Wasabi's in the building. So that's how we do it. It's a walk with Mel Archer with Untimitive Dance Company. Check them out on social media. Email them. Get on board. Sirshu Dyson of Tweed. Wanna Dyson. Ashila, Val. Thank you so much for tuning in, people. It's Mel Yopiel signing out. Yay.